Well, hello everybody. Sorry for the little bit of a late start here today. We have a banger on our hands. South Korea versus United States here. I am a noob and I'm joined by your favorite commentator, Blank Tap. Oh no, he's not here.
Oh no, he's not here. Panic! Panic! Panic!
So yeah, for the to fill everyone in on this first match or first map, Ruins of Opal was first picked, and even though South Korea put up a crazy single performance with a 700k by, let me just make sure I have the player correct, by Choco, 500k by Choco, United States had some pretty good high accuracies in Gilgamesh with 96, Pagetism with 93, Hopred with 95, just at gapping South Korea on that map, and will take it by 90k. It sounds like we're going into the United States Protect Fremont 1 Neptune to start us off with their list of picks. Yeah, South Korea did first pick Runes of Opal. For this Fremont 1 Neptune, it is a custom song by Sydosys here for this, specifically made for this five-digit World Cup. Wait, did we not pick Fremont 1? I'm hearing something change.
Apologies. No, I guess the ad riff didn't go through initially, so I had to reset stuff.
Okay. Sounds good. And there's my favorite commentator, Blank Tap. How are you doing today, my fellow?
Pretty good. I just got myself tea.
just
to warm myself up. It is midnight after all here, Mr. Do. And yeah.
And you have tea, and I have my lunch. Sorry, what was that again?
Oh no! Did we miss any map?
Yeah, we missed one map. I was telling the chat, Ruins of Opal.
I see.
And South Korea first picked it, and they had some pretty good combos. Choco basically full comboed the map, and like reverse choked the map. And Piers had a pretty good combo as well, but South Korea did not have the accuracies across the board. And USA had some crazy accuracies, like 96.5 on Gilgamesh, 95 on Hotbred. And they just were able to have lower combos, but higher accuracies. So they were able to pull that across the finish line.
All right. Let's see if South Korea can take this back, though. Not a great start for South Korea, indeed.
Mm-hmm, but it's, you know, one point at the end of the day. It only takes one match or one map to bring that back.
Indeed.
To even. But with this Fremont 1 pick, this was USA's Protect, I believe. Mm-hmm. And I can understand why. They have shown very, very high level in their speed roster, specifically with Stage My Mommy or Kisoy, as he what he knows. With the Hidden Hard Rock and Gilgamesh. Oh, he has actually decided to take Hidden this time. We've seen a Hidden Hard Rock with a Gilgamesh Nomad basically every round for the United States. But this time we see, I don't know who that is. Meow, 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 meow. These United States players need to get better names, man.
Yeah, I mean, it is a bit of a brain rot moment, but, you know, I mean, it's what makes them special, literally.
Oh, yeah.
Down 10k difference, and meow, 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 with the first miss. Still, the accuracy on their side, no longer as Filipino, is kind of a bit concerningly low ACK right now.
Mm-hmm. We didn't really talk about the South Korea roster at all either, but HG Jump with the HGHR and two other Hiddens on Civil Oath and Pale Citrus. Pretty normal mod combinations, and we see the HGHR from the United States and the
absolute collapse.
Yeah.
And now there's two big combo right now, noob.
Mm-hmm. At this break, they are seeing the situation they are in. These veteran tourney players should not be able to handle these nerves, but they are still here, looking at Choco and Pale Citrus on the side of South Korea and Filipino and meow, 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 meow on the United States side. I need to figure out who these guys' names are. I know Filipino's Copper.
All The alt coming in, a bit of a finger control section, Choco holding it down, Civil alt comboing as well, 100k difference, so in head just jump, finding the trick, Meow Meow and Filipino still locking it down, Gilgamesh and Belcetro still very, very much equal, 180k difference, but it's increasing right for the United States as Civil alt finds the miss, and as South Korea collapse as a team as a whole, Choco is the last one standing, but once again, it's a team game. And it's just not enough for one guy to carry everything to the finish line.
You see,
and United States.
You see, killing Copper with the crisp 90% ACK FC. He will be probably the only full combo in this lobby. And I jinxed him. Basically, the only full combo in this lobby. But with that 90% ACK not being the highest score in this lobby, Choco showing he is here to play today. But alas, not enough for South Korea. Yeah.
We're gonna throw it back to South Korea though. It's still very much the opening picks right now. Let's see if they can pull up a fight against the United States.
Yeah, it was quite a bold move to pick Ruins of Opal into this United States team, considering how strong they are at the gimmick and the rhythm too.
Yeah.
Looks like they're going into ESM, our Hidden 3 map, as their second pick. This map, probably one of the harder maps in this pool. It is your Hidden Tech Flow map. Mm-hmm. A lot of skill sets that are represented and just get harder on Hidden are shown in this map. A lot of flow, a little bit of tech aim control. You need to have... be on the top of your game with your Hidden roster to be put up good scores. And this South Korea team has shown to be pretty good at Hidden, all things considered.
Alright, double cost bracket coming in. Pierce is in as well, Civil out. CFR on the other side for United States.
Yeah, he's a... these four players definitely expected to be in for these Hidden maps. But outside that, I don't really know who is the fourth player on this for South Korea. I know the United States has a pretty deep Hidden roster, but they, outside of ZFR, that's the only player I look at. I'm like, oh, Hidden, right? There's probably one I'm missing. It looks like we're lobby sitting. It looks like we're chilling. We're, you know, brushing up on the map a little bit, maybe.
Absolutely.
Using those 2 minutes wisely. Definitely needed for a map like this.
Japan is in though, but United States on the clock, on the timer. Still need three players on the board. Hot Breath and Gilgamesh coming in tight, alright, quick as a lightning, that's nice. Let's get right into our top map,
I'm so sorry, Haxagon, I know, he is a really good hidden player as well. I forgot this man is on this team. And then Hot Breath, tights.
Oh, I see, okay.
These USA players, man. But yeah, Hot Breath and Gilgamesh rounding out the United States roster, also not a huge surprise. Hopred, a good hidden player. Gilgamesh can basically play everything.
Indeed. Start. Good luck. Have fun. It's time for Hidden 3.
This map takes no time to give you some of the wacky patterns. You saw that pattern, which took half the lobby, Silver Oath, Brackets, and Gilgamesh going down, and Choco behind him.
Yeah, it's already a 1v2, but still very much the opening, and not in the accuracy though, as Pyrrhus finds the first slider break of his own ZFR, and Hotbred still staying absolutely stunning right now in this beginning section, 99% and 98% accuracy, respectively. 50k difference, you know, he stays still looking so good right now in this opening, civil out, finding another slider break, and now South Korea gonna work a bit, lots right now, because this is just, yeah.
Yeah, looking like an uphill battle here. Hotbred on his own. We do see some supporting combos across the way, but Choco coming down, that was the highest from South Korea. Not going to help their case at all.
All right, second round, though. Second case, section noob. It's still kind of... It's still kind of there. The fight is still going on. Gilgamesh and Hotbred still with double combo, but low on the other side. Pyrrhus and double brackets. Gilgamesh finding a miss with no one to trade. Now going into the slow section now with Tides finding the chain miss. Pyrrhus, double brackets, civil out, and Choco recovering quite well, but there's the trade from ZFR and Pyrrhus. Hotbred is still hot, but he's fighting against the double bracket. 120k difference, and it's going to stay that way for now.
Yeah, and even though South Korea's down 100k, there's a lot of potential score being held in these almost full combos here. Double brackets, Hotbred. Either of these players miss, especially Hotbred, could bring this back towards South Korea, especially with the other players not really holding a good supporting combo.
Yeah, absolutely. It's all relying on Hotbred right now, but Pyrrhus falls. That's first step, but Gilgamesh, a step back, but double bracket with the miss. Hotbred is the only one left remaining with a huge combo right now. Choco is half of him, and I don't think he's strong enough to clutch up. It's a 1v1.5. And into this slow section, Hotbred staying untouched, staying perfect, staying on his lane, locking in with 1060 combo.
Yeah, not necessarily out of it yet. Choco has a pretty good recovery combo, but Hotbred just out in his own stratosphere right now. And with this a little bit of slower section to bank combo, he's only going to grow that lead.
Absolutely. 1,000 combo still climbing up, up and up. Hotbred on a hot streak. Can he full combo this whole map into the absolute pinnacle of the difficulty of this map? ZFR holding, Choco still not holding, actually finding a miss as I say that, and South Korea has fallen, only Pyrrhus remaining. Hotbred finally finding a miss, but it's a bit too late right now, unless Pyrrhus full combo this whole section, and even then, it might be too late for South Korea to bring this hidden tree back to their side. One more part in this climax of a section, and Pyrrhus will fall as well, noob.
Yeah, no combo left, no score to be had, and the last bit of this map will bring USA into their second breakpoint of this match, looking very, very dominant.
Now the ending section, just one more closing statement and it's all done. United States will be taking their second breakpoint and third point overall. And this is just not the best of stuff for South Korea right now.
Yeah, and I think that this just highlights the crazy depth of the United States roster. I know ZFR is sitting here thinking, I know I could have doubled my score. And I know Hexagon Tights is probably thinking the same thing. Like, you have to go up against a team like this, and any one of them could just pop off and do something like Hotbred just did with a 600k on a finals hidden map.
Well, then there's still a fight to be had, but that fight is slowly but surely dissipating. South Korea needs to come up for a reply soon enough, to say the least. Now, going into United States pick this time, Pierre is saying same. I know how it feels. Hidden is one of the... Any hidden fix is one of the most difficult thing to be consistent on and actually full combo and perform when you really need to. So, it is what it is. A bit of a mistake there. But... what's be done is just... Yeah. It's not so... okay, what... What will the United States pick this time? The world is their oyster right now. They can go from anywhere.
They have a lot of flexibility to go wherever they want.
Yeah.
They feel comfy enough, they could be like, We're gonna pick at you, South Korea, so even if you start to pull it back, we're gonna be at a point where every single map left in this pool, I know we can win on. And having that mental drain is like definitely something you have to think about.
Absolutely.
Or they could just say, okay, let's go find a map that to test the waters a little bit, maybe like an aim map, or they could go into just the crazy, like, gimmicky or stuff like Wing My Way or Pump It. Just try to get to a point in the match where you feel really good on the rest of the maps in the pool.
Double time one indeed, then a bit of a kind of speed hybrid with aim, just kind of introducing themselves to the concept, you know. Noob. So yeah, this is the first time I'm seeing this map though, and this is one goofy background.
Yeah, this and is one... not only is it a goofy background, it's a goofy song. This is a Spanish speaking meme song.
I see.
It's like via Legend of Zelda. I cannot speak. But yeah, the name of the game here, this is pretty fast, this is a lot of aim, and it's not super tapping intensive. There is a little bit of tapping, but no one's really going to be like, oh, I can't play the tapping portion of this map. It's all about air and 10.3 aim.
Absolutely.
I hear Dorito, that's good enough.
Good enough. Yeah, this is one of many AJ Mosca customs in this pool, and personally, I don't think that man misses when he maps tournament maps. I haven't seen a bad one yet. So yep, all aim players come in. This is your time. We have not had a really aim map this match yet. We're already 3 points in. Come on, it's your time now.
Indeed.
See, people from United States like Kisoe and Killing Copper in makes a lot of sense. And people like HD Jump from South Korea coming in making sense too.
Dorito. Alright, there we go. Good luck. Have fun. We shall begin. Dale, Zelda, dale. Extended, actually. Oh, yeah.
Yep, we gotta get that little bit of longer map in here for this DT1 slot. Looks like Calburn's taking a little bit of their time to get into the lobby. All good. We'll get in there eventually.
Alright, let's get right into this one. The jump with the first miss though, it's not too great of a start record, but they are leading by a tiny bit. This is going to be kind of a quick map, so gotta stay on their toes.
Yeah, but this map does not let up. We see Zab missing, and these patterns, you can see these bursts, you need to be focused in. You can't just like zone out and be like, okay, let me focus on my aim. There is some tapping here. Zab chain missing. The only one really struggling, they should jump a couple misses as well, but this is a South Korea lead by a significant margin from this point.
No, man, not that right, that is very important. Only Kisoi remains against Choco and Civil out, and we've seen how Choco clutches from time to time again. And this time, he actually has help from Civil out, and if they both can hold, this might be a huge break point for them. And there it is, Kisoi is gone, but so does Choco. Civil out, the last one remaining.
Yeah, and Civil Oath is banking a lot of score for South Korea, and that miss means that United States is actually in the driver's seat. And there's definitely enough time for them to take the point back.
Yeah, but so it is back to 90k difference between male finding a miss. Only HG champs remaining against Hot Breath on a hot streak right now. Only quarter of the map remaining, one more KA section. Can they hold on? Down to 60k! HG jump! Save South Korea! He cannot! But Hot Breath makes it back! It's the bakery close! It's United States! A streak finally broken. South Korea, can they hold on? Buckle up your seatbelt, because South Korea is going on a trip. 40k difference, and it's here to stay. And finally, they will get their first point and a break point nonetheless. And finally, we have a match.
Yeah, South Korea is buckled in because they've started their trip. They've gotten their first point on the board. And there's more to come here. That was their pick. That was what you would quote-unquote be expected. But definitely a... Wait, no, that wasn't. That was United States
that
pick.
Was, yeah. That was USS pick. That's why it's huge.
That's exactly what they needed. We're going immediately into the Hard Rock 2. It'll eventually get changed. We're chilling. It's Hard Rock 2, a map made by Doomsday, a song made by Doomsday. But this is a Yolks Pie, what is it called? A Yolks Pie map within the set. And if you know how Yolks Pie maps, you can kind of understand what this is going for. We're going to see a little bit of awkward patterning here. Nothing too crazy. A very, I wouldn't say simple, straightforward Hard Rock 2, but definitely leaning into the precision aspect in terms of aim.
Oh, Hot Rock 2, okay. Doomsday song as well. Holy moly, my goat.
Yeah, that man just does everything. He maps, he makes music, he plays really well.
Yeah.
He's a mouse player, which is a plus in my end. You know?
He's playing tablet recently. I mean, he can everything, man.
Yeah, he can everything, man.
All right. Double bracket. Civil Oath and Choco is in the lobby, Hot Breath and Killing Copper as well, and just wait. Yeah, we're waiting. Can South Korea cook on Hot Rock 2? Speaking of cooking, I just got chicken wing. Hell yeah.
You love a good old chicken wing. Some good food and a good match. What else can you expect? Yeah, sure.
Hope you're all having a wonderful...
I'll finish the thought, because Blink Tap is currently eating his chicken wing. I hope everyone's having a wonderful day. Today, I've been having a good time. I woke up a little earlier than usual today, did some gaming.
Let's go.
Oh. I was gonna continue the bit stage, but no, I'm not gonna.
Alright, it's time. Hot Rock 2. Length of location by Doomsday. Precision maps, yes, 6.5. Your classic, yours truly, 6.6 star rating. Here we go. Going to the first job, no misses just yet. But things are gonna get a bit more harder than that. For now, just a tease jump for now as double bracket finds the first miss. 3v4, right off the bat. Yeah, this kind of awkward spacing with the burst. Just a sudden stop, you gotta be always be ready, and Hot Breath is not hard right now. As Panties follows suit, it's a 3v1 situation. 70k in the lead for South Korea as they bulldoze through this first one-third section. United States, though, can they fight back right now, noob? They are still going the distance, but only Kisoy and CFR with their returning combo. The streams coming in, 200 BPM, very difficult to civil out and ZFR, Tracy Road, Shock and Hot Brain, Stas is out, it's all up to Kelburn against Kisoy, and Kelburn will win the fight right now, actually. South Korea still on the distance, Kelburn with a miss, but Double Bracket is still matching ZFR and slowing her down. Panatism with the miss once more, going into this section, the last section, one third of the map remaining, 200k difference, Kisoy trying to fight back as well as Hot Brad, but Sibyl and Choco is right there to stop them from getting to their king, Double Bracket still going the distance, still reaching for the stars, still reaching for the highest score in this lobby, Kisoy trying to fight back, here comes another stream, Sibyl out with a miss, 150k difference, it's their time, can United States bring it back, 100k difference, but Kisoy and Hot Brad finds the miss. Double Bracket, Choco and Kelburn still keeping him alive. South Korea will float, South Korea will sail, and they will keep on going and getting their second point on the board. And right now, things went from looking absolutely grim and up to doing to becoming possible. South Korea's second point on the board with Choco S rank. Can they break point United States' current pick? And if so, that is going to be a huge, huge mental lead. This is it. United States' pick in this current moment might be the most important pick to decide how this match will go. My chicken wing on my hand got cold while I was talking. Damn it, guys. Why was it so close? But anyways, United States, what will they pick?
Oh, wait. Okay, hold up. I think my computer's dying. Whoopsie.
Whoopsie.
Anyway, I have no words for that. You had a glorious presentation of that map there. Like, South Korea just looking a little bit better across the board than United States on that map. Yeah, give me a minute. I'll fix
this. No, take your time, brother. Mr. Streamer, the Hard Rock 2 pick is wrong. South Korea pick Hard Rock 2. And now, United States will pick Blue Zeddy, ladies and gentlemen. Do you see it? Do any of you see it? Hot Breath coming in, Civil Old Kelburn. Alright.
Step in for now. So yeah, this map in particular, I mean, you know, everyone knows Zenith, although this difficulty definitely a little bit less known, a little bit more on the awkward side, I would say. There is definitely a stamina element to it, don't get me wrong, but I think for this map in particular, what I tend to notice is actually some of the kind of in-between patterns between the streams actually kind of mess up players more often than not. The flow in this is, although difficult, it's definitely not the main highlight of this map, I would argue. I think the big one that stands out to me are some of the doubles after sliders. There's like pauses in the streams that can really mess people up. There's also some of the buzz sliders in particular that can mess people up if they're too focused on trying to hit everything. So, you know, definitely a test of comfort, especially given the fact that it is still, you know, Blue Zenith, it's still 200 BPM streams and whatnot. So, if you're not really up to the challenge for a marathon stream map, adding that extra layer of awkwardness is definitely a difficult one to do, especially in a tournament. So, yeah, I think the rosters here are looking pretty solid. I think this is the first appearance of YHSPHD. I don't know what that means.
Oh, yeah, it is, yeah.
I have a feeling it's Korean, but typed on the English keyboard. I'm gonna take my bets on that one. There's a fun little lore for you guys. Forum's skin that you use for Burning Star. If you type that out in Korean, it's a funny little word. I will not say what it is, but you can infer things, okay? So this is a common thing for Korean keyboards.
Ah, I see. Okay, then. Just a bit of trivia. Very nicely, but you know, it's time for no mod 2. 200 BPM, the 1-2 jumps already coming in. Civil Oak will find the first slider break, but that's still very much early on in this no mod 2. Combo is going to be plentiful. That is both a blessing and a curse. It's so easy to just miss and invalidate your basically 700 combo. But if you miss in the beginning, it doesn't really matter for now.
Name of the game and on this map in particular is going to be holding on to as long of a combo as possible, or maybe both, getting good accuracy. Mm. Especially on a stream map like this, any mistaps or misnames can honestly tank your accuracy up to 2%, so gotta be real careful. Here comes a small jump section, nothing too crazy, but hidden jump actually going to be the first one to break on that one. So that is going to be a pretty big loss for Korea at the moment. Pretty easy, slow section here. Surely no one misses on this one, right?
Indeed.
No
Absolutely.
Way.
I mean, come on now. United States, they are strong enough. They are independent enough to not need any help in this situation, in this section right now. But going to another stream section now. A big, kind of awkward pause. And meow, 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 will reply with his own miss. And that's it. The difference is not much, and the accuracy drop is absolutely fatal. 27k difference, Kahli.
Yeah, and as I mentioned before, if you break your combo, your next goal has to be maintaining accuracy to some degree, especially towards the ending of this map. It's pretty hard to keep comboing everything through to the end. Well, it's going to be an awkward missing from YHS here, and ooh, now it's going to be 1 FC to 3 at the moment. One high combo from Civil Oath and a recovery combo from Hidden Jump, but Meow is matching that. There goes Hot Bread, though, missing on a jump. Oh, I love stream players. I can speak as one myself. That is pretty normal.
Yeah. Right now, though, still, the score is still equal, but Coco will find the miss!
Well, that's
the Civil Oath remaining.
Right before the hard part, too. And speaking of the buzz sliders, here we go. Tights is gonna be the first one to break on that one. As I mentioned, shaking is way. Oh my god, he's so shaky. He's so shaky.
Absolutely.
Holy
but Yuga Man still stone cold as hell. Civil Odd, however, disputing a civil court. But there it is, the miss. There's the trade. HD jump. Can he go the distance in this stream? Meow, meow, meow. He's still contesting the 130k difference.
And that is another
and now the accuracy is gonna kick him soon enough.
Oh, meow, please. Get a little earlier, man. There goes Hidden Jump. Oh my, guys, please.
Guys, come on, that's not the. That's not a jump
right now.
Such a 450 combo right now, still increasing. Meow, meow, meow with 1k combo. Still putting his team in the lead while PhD is just kind of struggling right now with his accuracy and combo alike. And now the stamina problem is becoming clearer and clearer for each of our players. While PhD is now down in the drain. Hot Breath finding yet again another miss. And PhD. Oh my goodness, that is just absolutely heart-wrenching, heart-breaking. Someone send this man to the hospital because he's running out of breath. Choco, on the other hand, trying to stay alive. 200k difference into the last stream. Meow, meow, meow has no more combo. Civil Owen and Choco still fighting back. 200k difference. Even with 2-bit combo, 3-bit combo for South Korea, PhD is just unable to keep up, and the lead's just not going to be any smaller. It's too slow. It's too late. South Korea.
Oh no, and they had such a fighting chance with the last score. And the view from the out pretty much says exactly how the US is feeling, because all things considered, that genuinely could have gone to Korea, except for the last player difference. And that is going to be a United States win on their own pick, but man, that looked very, very bad for them. If Choco FC, that genuinely would have just been a Korea win, like straight up. Yeah. That accuracy is more than good enough, outscoring everyone else in the lobby. Got a little scary with the chain misses from Hexagon. Got a little nervous on that. And the kind of unexpected misses during some of the easier sections. As I mentioned, those intermediate patterns, right? Everything in between the streams is what you gotta watch out for. And I'm just saying, we saw six people miss on those four-star jumps, okay? Saw six people. So, I don't know, man. It's just how it is. So... anyways, here we go into the next map for Korea, actually. It's going to be their pick now. Luckily for them, they don't have to worry about tapping in this pool anymore. Pretty much all of the quote-unquote raw tapping maps are gone. Maybe you could argue Fremont 3. I wouldn't really say so, at least not at this level. So this is a pretty interesting availability here. We have Hard Rock 1 and Nomad 1 available. Still got the Hard Rock 3. Nomad 3, Nomad 4, Nomad 5, the whole kind of shebang of awkward Nomad maps still up for debates. And of course, the classic DT4, cannot forget that one. But it's actually going to be a hidden 2 pick from the side of Korea, going to be going with their Protect, pretty understandable. Think you might want to throw the US for a loop after what just happened on Nomad 2. Can't really blame them, so... gotta play into the strengths of some of your best players. You know, big shout out to Pieris. Probably the scariest one out of the whole list. Why is it saying the US pick? It's definitely not. Okay, here we go. But yeah, this hidden two, we did see a bit before in the previous match. This is going to be a more of an aim-oriented, kind of slider-heavy hidden two. Not exactly overlaps, like perfect overlaps, but there are definitely something you have to look out for. Name of the game here is going to be the aim control on top of the low BPM and the ARA too. Not a precision pick, you know, sometimes ARA hidden tend to be CS5 as just kind of a layover from being a Fremont 2, but this one, no, it's pretty pretty cut and dry ARA hidden. You gotta know what you're doing. So, yeah, this, I think the big play to look out for here is going to be Pierce. It's pretty obvious, you know. The lower the AR gets, the better he is, which is pretty obvious. ZFR, also a pretty scary opponent on this one, although I think, if I'm not mistaken, she struggles on slightly lower AR. I mean, she's definitely good at it, but she's not, like, as comfortable as she would be if it was, like, AR9. Sure. But, you know, either or, definitely a good thing for them. Although, I think United States, also, they do have a... I think Gilgamesh is pretty good at how we are hidden as well, just as kind of a side effect of being really good at easy, but hard to say for sure.
Yeah. Also, a tiny bit of trivia for you, Kahli, and for the audience. Pieris actually played this map 2 hours ago on another tournament, and I mean, I'm not gonna spoiler the scores, but he contested Yogspy and Epiforce, that's what I'm gonna say.
Yeah, that's about the expected outcome. I don't think anyone really thought otherwise. I don't think anyone's gonna look at Pieris, like the guy that FC Furiosa Melodia with easy, and be like, yeah, I think this guy's gonna struggle on ARA. Like, I don't see it. I don't see it. Nope, I don't think he's gonna be good enough to handle this one. Nope. But to be fair, though, we did see this in the previous match as well. It is a team game, and I think on this map in particular, you can't entirely count on one player to carry. Maybe the exception here will be Pieris, but you know, it's still kind of a hard call. Not exactly as binary as like raw speed, for example. So I think we're also gonna be going into a timeout at the moment. So just gonna give the US some time to kind of sort themselves out here.
Yep. Yes. Great time for me to keep on gambling. Okay, playing Mahjong.
You play Mahjong in the middle of the red. Hey, I'm not any better. I'm playing a gacha game right now. I can't speak.
Alright, nice. Wait, what are you playing? What are you playing?
I'm playing the Toho gacha game, because of course I am.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah, we're just waiting. Wait, what tournament did Pierre just play this in, actually? Was it the Tutka one, or else?
Yeah, of course it's the Tutka one.
Ah, perfect. So, yeah, for those of you who are curious about what he might pull off, there you go. Yeah, we're just gonna be waiting here. Again, gotta give the US some time to kind of get their things together. I mean, I can imagine how stressful this is for them, you know? They were in the lead by a pretty good amount, and Korea did claw back some points, so, you know. Can't really sleep on them just yet, right? Every little bit's gonna count here. Shoutouts to Yoshi Lover 456 in the chat. Love that guy. If he was on the US right now, like, straight up, if he was on the US, like, they would just win this map instantly. I'm not even kidding.
Yeah, Yoshi Lover. I still remember, like, 4 years ago he beat me. I still haven't met him since, but someday I'll take my revenge further. Someday.
Nah, Yoshi always wins, man. That's just how it goes.
Nah, he'd win.
We'll make Yoshi 5 digits, and then the world's gonna explode. Trust me on this one. Okay, I think we're actually ready to go now. Timeout seems to be done. So Hot Bread Tight's gonna be rounding out the United States roster. Pretty understandable. At the square brackets, yep. YHS and Shogo is in South Korea, so... You could argue a little bit more of a team-oriented roster for United States, but South Korea, I mean, you know, they're not necessarily bad at the skill set, and you still got your hyper-carry player on this kind of stuff, so here we go into the map.
Yeah, this perfect stacking is gonna kill a lot of people, but it's a sacrifice that the mappers are willing to make. See if they can pull it off. Going to the first section, though. Yeah, looking kind of clean for now.
First break on Choco, not gonna matter too much just yet. I mean, misses are gonna be pretty common on this map in particular, but at the moment, US is gonna lead by just a tiny amount. I do think accuracies are actually better on the US side at the moment, looking at Gilgamesh and Hotbread. Oh, actually kind of a collapse on Korea at the moment. Only Pierre is holding on to the FC. YHS and square brackets not at all this time. Meanwhile, no breaks to trade on the side of US just yet. We'll see if that changes though as we get into the harder reading sessions.
Absolutely, that's the make or break session as always.
Oh, okay, double break from United States. Gilgamesh and ZFR matching the break from YHS. Now eyes on Hotbread and Tights. There goes Tights though. Oh, Hotbread breaks.
Here comes the back and forth. It's done. An absolute collapse, and this is what I'm talking about, this reading section. It's just sometimes too much to handle if you're not specialized enough. And Pyrrhus, he has a PhD in Hidden 2, and he is just showing it off to everyone in this lobby.
Yeah,
just flaunting his diploma.
Yeah, I think the main point of contention here is that Pyrrhus is no stranger to low AR Hidden. I mean... If there's one thing he can do, it is easy, and also easy hidden, which is kind of demonic if you think about it. So, this probably feels like AR 10 to him, no cap, because he's used to AR 3, AR 4 hidden. And, you can see it with the accuracy too, 99% matching Gilgamesh, who's also an easy player himself. Like, just the level of difference here is huge. Square bracket's gonna get a break, so that is gonna slow down, but Choco with the supporting combo. And Gilgamesh, Tights, and ZFR working to make this happen for the US. Still not entirely free for Korea, just okay, that's a six-way break. Five-way actually, never mind. Okay, more on the side of Korea. Oh, there goes Tights, there goes ZFR. It's a massacre for the side of the US.
Absolutely, and Pierre is not looking to be stopped, ladies and gentlemen. What are we watching right now? Pierre is the one-man show. Holy moly, South Korea getting saved by Pyrrhus, the Superman in reading. And would you believe it, the lead increasing without any mercy, Kahli. What is this guy doing?
I mean, this is looking like the Boston Massacre right now. I'm not even gonna lie.
Wait,
there's no way
he's doing it.
Is he gonna do it? Oh.
Oh my god, he's still going! One more section! the P stands for perfection. South Korea takes their 6th point.
I guess the team factor, as I mentioned before, not actually going to matter here because basically everyone got about the same score as each other. Choco actually outscoring everyone on the US individually. But Pieris, I mean, I don't know, man. This is one thing you cannot leave open with this guy. It's going to be hidden in low AR. Well, pretty much anything low AR, honestly. That also does leave Nomad 5, I think. If I remember correctly, I think Nomad 5 is still technically up. So
it's precision. Oh, but the second precision, yeah, it's definitely doable. But yeah, South Korea definitely just kind of dangling the keys to Nomad 5 in front of USA's face.
Yeah, I think the US now, they're gonna be on the back foot. Definitely a lot more going on over there. For now, I think the things that have been working for the US are pretty much anything that has some sort of mechanics in it. So, unironically, Free Mod 3 could be seeing a Hard Rock 1, No Mod 1 even, right? Those are probably the safest bets for the United States. Yep. But Korea, now that they have that confidence coming in from here, okay, well, I say confidence as you say, I'm shaking too much right now, but you get the idea. From that pop-up performance from Pieris, it does give them a little bit more leeway. They can definitely lean more into Nomad 5. And honestly, if they really feel like it, they could potentially try out DT4 or Nomad 4. Those are on the kind of more dense side and a little bit less on the mechanics. So that is definitely a good path for them to keep going. But yeah, US, I mean, they were looking hot before, but I don't know, only 1 point in the lead so far. Let's see what they go for next. It's going to be a Hard Rock 3 pick, time for Violet Rose. Let me go ahead and make sure this is picked correctly here. Any second round.
Hopefully.
Yes.
And there we go.
This map in particular, pretty well-known kind of rhythm control alt. I think this map in particular, a little bit on the easier side compared to some other versions of this song, or just this kind of map in general. But it is still pretty rhythm-heavy, so, you know, even if you are kind of your traditional speed player, you still gotta have that finger control in you. And, you know, this is a very different type of finger control. You know, it goes from 152 alt to, I think, 225-ish, maybe, kind of 1/6 patterns. A couple, I'm not sure if there's any 1/3s in this, like any notable ones, but, you know, still pretty difficult to hit, nonetheless. That transition, not exactly easy for everyone.
Yeah.
Also, yeah, a good thing to point out here, as mentioned in the chat, this is, it is a solid 3 in the morning for Korea right now. Yeah, I don't know how they are surviving right now. Like, yeah, 3 in the morning, that's crazy. Now, granted, I think they rescheduled to this time, so that's entirely on them, but it's crazy they're putting out these performances at 3 in the morning. Like, damn.
Only a couple people do that, really.
Yeah. I personally can relate to this just because usually my peak time is actually like 2 or 3 in the morning, but I'm not really a normal person. So actually, maybe it's a Korean thing. Maybe it's a Korean thing, honestly. I don't know. But either way, for waiting for the rest of the roster here. Are we actually going to be seeing Gilgamesh play this one? Huh, interesting. Okay. Maybe Kisoy making a reappearance here. Kaelbert as well. But, yeah, I'm kind of surprised by the Gilgamesh one. Huh. Okay. I mean, he's not really a Hard Rock player from what I know, but I mean, if he's feeling up to the challenge in terms of the rhythm control, that's pretty valid. So, here we go.
Absolutely.
I think a big one to look out for here is Kaelbert. He did pop off on the Hard Rock 2. Not exactly the same map, don't get me wrong, but you know, he's still definitely competent on Hard Rock nonetheless. And honestly, if you're a Hard Rock player, sometimes that's all you really need.
Oh yeah. Oh my god, just diving right into this one. No. not one third big spacing catching Soy off guard, but the Ooh. Next stream catching Calvin and Choco with a massive chain miss, double bracket as well. It's a 1v2 right off the bat and massive accuracy advantage to the side of the US.
Yeah, not looking too hot for Korea at the moment. Only Hidden Jump holding onto an FC and honestly fighting for his life on the accuracy here. 91. Although it's not like the rest of his team's doing much better anyways. That's a full squad wipe from Korea. Actually, that's a full squad wipe from basically everyone. Combos have reset across the board. And that does favor the US by quite a good amount, as we are seeing the higher accuracies across the board. Solid 92, 96, even the 98 coming in from Gilgamesh. I apologize, I was not familiar with your game, Gilgamesh. But meanwhile for Korea, they are really struggling here. Not even 90% coming in from them. Especially with the lack of combos across the board, it's just kind of over already, honestly. Only about a third of the map remaining, but it's going to take a bit of a miracle for Korea to get any sort of recovery score here. Unfortunately, with score V2, axe scaling kind of makes it impossible to get big comebacks to happen, and we're seeing a bit of that here.
Yeah, man, it is what it is.
Yeah, a bit of a reset for combo on the US, but see how little that score lead is changing, even with the better combos on side of Korea. Honestly, the only comparable score at the moment is Hidden Jump, and even then, still not going to be able to match up against the US. So, solid win for the United States on their pick as the Hard Rock 3.
Mm-hmm.
Probably should have picked that earlier, but hindsight's 2020, so can't exactly say that too straightforward. But yeah, you can just see the level of comfort here between the two teams. Jeez, the 10-100s from Gilgamesh. My god. That's pretty hard on a map like that. I'm not gonna lie with you.
Oh yeah. United States two steps away from knocking South Korea out of the competition. But yeah, let's see what they can do.
As I mentioned, they still have the Nomad 5 hanging over their head, so, they can always go for that. They do have a couple other options if they want to gamble, but to be honest, given that this is potentially the last pick of the match, I think it's probably just safer to go Nomad 5. Don't risk anything, you know?
Oh, yeah.
I got that reference from Hot Bread. Get it? Because the AE86, the funny car from Initial V.
Bruh.
What? It's a deep reference, man. Don't you love cars?
Man.
That's not a car, that's a horse. Or a sheep.
Okay. Alright.
Was that supposed to be a horse or a sheep? I couldn't tell.
I don't know, I was trying to...
Oh my god, wait. Big news.
Oh my god, Eva!
Oh. Boys, we are back. This is a pick of all time. Instead of going Nomad 5, they're doing the thing. It's Wing My Way, and of course the original one too. Let's go. So yeah, of course, a classic double time alt map, legendary, honestly, so to speak. Probably B2B's most well-known map, aside from Woyao Jinkula, but that's a little personal bias there. So this is a pretty kind of awkward flow, I would say. There's not really jumps in this, if there are, I mean, maybe the beginning if you really want to be pedantic, but that doesn't really count. So
yeah.
Name of the game here, all about the awkward flow and definitely a bit of finger control too. Even if the map sets don't really seem that intimidating, it is still pretty difficult nonetheless. The thing I'm more curious about is who's playing this. Because, truth be told, I can't really think of, like, a specific player on either team that's like, yeah, they're insta-FCing this, because this is a very specific kind of DTL map.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
You can't even say, like, oh, like, someone just plays random maps of DT. No, you gotta be, like, the old map player with DT. You know? Think, like, Air You. You gotta be like that.
Oh, yeah.
You don't really run into those that often. So,
scream.
Especially on this map in particular, which is probably like the most well-known old DT alt map. You kind of have the issue of, I've seen this before, or I've played this before. Mm. I don't think I can get a good score right now. And I think everyone's kind of feeling that. So, maybe the name of the game here is get the most boomer players you have. Like, straight up, just get the grab the old and be like, just send it, man. Maybe. Seeing ZFR. Oh, I think Kenji is making a reappearance after a bit of time. Civil Oath, that is a proper boomer right there. Sorry to be rude, right, but that guy has been playing for so long. Not quite as old as when the map came out, but he definitely knows this one. So here we go. It's time for Wing My Way. I think it's the first time it's been picked this weekend. Hopefully we see it more. But for now, actually a pretty important point for Korea, truth be told. A lot on the line here, because if they lose this, that's going to give US match points. And given some of the maps remaining, I would not want to be match points. So.
Oh, absolutely. Ugh.
I'm going to pump up the music if you guys don't mind.
Turn that tune off. And already we are seeing misses left, right, and center, and we are going to see who's truly the boomers of the boomers. AC done, kill him, he strikes it out, CFR with the miss, but Pyrrhus and Choco, all them missing the 7-man squad. Free falling, call them freedom dive or something. But right now, South Korea is behind by 30k difference.
Yeah, right now, Civil Oath really the only one with a low score, but he is recovering it very quickly as he builds up his accuracy. And now we get into the main hard part of the map. The Wiggle gonna mess up Choco, but here comes some of the flow. Another miss from Choco. A slider break from ZFR, and that is gonna equalize things. Oh my god, this is such a nice edge.
There's only one more section after this one. One difficult section, can they hit it soon enough? They're still going the distance, they're still not giving up. Never back down, never up. South Korea still with the advance. 50k difference, but now down to 30k.
Oh,
one last string. Can they hold on? Pierce with a miss, but they're still holding on. United States, can they still hold this away? But the miss, is that a good enough threat for South Korea? Can they hold on? They hold on!
And the chain miss from Gilgamesh, that's the one deciding factor.
Wing their way in the South Korea flying high. Oh my god.
If only the US knew how close that was. Literally, the chain miss from Gilgamesh at the end there. I'm sorry to single him out, but literally he dropped like 20k score. And that's actually just like enough of a difference. It was so close, but unfortunately not going to be enough for the United States. But very fortunately for Korea, going to be getting a very important point on their own pick here. A very risky one at that, but you know they still have that no mod 5 going for them. And that's really going to matter here. The gamble paid off. Oh my god. Sorry. Okay. You just got winged my way. Anyways.
You're just wing your way, your friends.
I want to make that a meme now. Just start like sending Wing My Way to people as like a jump scare. They're kind of funny.
Just a random meme video, random cat video, and just like, you just got Wing My Way.
It's like a random meme edit. You know, it's like the April Fool's meme with all of the lights. It's like that, but with Wing My Way.
True.
The Wing My Way car. Any Wing My Car.
Oh my god. Who has that? I only have the muddy buff version.
I think I have it. I don't know. I have to look for it, bro. The problem is I'm streaming. Yeah. I can't exactly do that. But anyways, very important win for South Korea. Still cannot get over how close that was for them. Looked a little doomed in the beginning. That little accuracy for Sibolov definitely hurt them. But still, that combo at the end for a hidden jump was enough. He did get that one miss. Time for a 3 pick from the United States. It's going to be one of the last picks remaining in this match. And this one a little bit more tapping oriented, not exactly fully. speed or stamina nonetheless, but especially with the mods, this does get pretty difficult. There's a lot of awkward flow, a lot of finger control to consider. Some of the sliders here, definitely gotta be worried about as well. Definitely no slouch on that one. I guess you could kind of put this into more of like a flow mech tech. If that, there's a lot of buzzwords I just said there, but that's kind of probably the closest description I can give of it, you know? So, definitely gonna be seeing a pretty big roster swap. And, right now, I think we're seeing Filipina make his first appearance after a little bit. Wait, is Pierce actually going easy on this? Oh, okay. Well, no. That's so stupid. Of course he's gonna go easy on this.
Alright, yes. The goat is on goaty, ladies and gentlemen. The grass is green, and it will be eaten. Pierce with the easy soon enough. The green moth for the green goat.
And actually, kind of surprised the US aren't letting Gilgamesh play easy on this one. Although, I would argue Gilgamesh isn't as well-known for his easy ability, he is still very good at easy, nonetheless. And I actually do think if you can read this, this is actually significantly easier. So, I don't know. It is what it is, I guess. Either way, let's see some of those mod combinations. I think I need to panic. Gilgamesh's mods are not showing up.
Absolutely.
One moment. Oh, wait, he's going no mod. Okay, alright then. Interesting.
Right, let him cook, I suppose. Alright, let's get right into this one. Very dense for the easy player, but Pierce holding on strong right now. And the United States still fighting other Choco and Stage My Mommy will find the first traits.
Yeah, and you have to keep in mind, folks, that the multiplier for easy, if I'm not mistaken, is 1.75. So, whatever you see on the score lead, just remember Pierce is there, and the more combo he gets, the way more impactful his score is going to be.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, though, everyone else is actually holding up pretty strong. Oh, actually, my bad. I forgot the tournament overlay on the stream calculates this easy multiplier. It's just on my end, it doesn't. My bad, folks. Got a little jump scared there. Although, honestly, even with this multiplier, it's still pretty close. Pierce got a miss. Wait, when did he miss? I didn't even notice that. That's not good.
Just like 10 seconds ago, but now here comes the stream. Can they hold up? United States still contesting heavily in this point onwards. You got my sense, ZFR still holds on very nicely. Still only 20k difference, but one miss and everything might come. They still have the map to be played.
Yeah, watch out for those triple FCs. There goes Stage, though. It's still really, difference. Really close.
Here comes the stream.
Oh, there goes Caleb.
This is it!
It's gonna make it even better for the United States. There goes Choco. Oh no.
Still two full combo on the board. HD jump, the last bastion of hope for South Korea. United States, keep on going on. What is the kilometer, they say? Still going absolutely haywire. 300k in the lead, and Pierce will fall. And United States, once again, gets away with an absolute lead.
Yeah, that is a very brutal team score for the United States. They're really putting their foot down and saying, nuh-uh, you are doing that. That is powerful. Two-way FC, plus a very good supporting score from ZFR. I thought Killing Copper slider broke. He did not. He just has 91 ACK. My bad. It is a two-way FC, plus a 930k from ZFR. Really, the only person that struggled there was Stage My Mommy, but he was doing the hidden hard rock gamble, so cannot count him out for that one. And yeah, Korea snaps. They're pissed. Yep. Yep. Okay.
Yep. Number five. Yeah.
To the surprise.
You wanna play? Let's play.
Yep. They just, they, Korea decided they're gonna be chamber. Cause, it's time for Nomad 5, the AR6, it's like AR6 CS6, I think, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, this is a map of all time. I think the name of the game here is the fact that the reading players on Korea still generally pretty good, but the fact that Pierre is there is going to be a little bit scary for the US. They do have Gilgamesh as a potential counterpart. Do not get that wrong, but that also means everyone else has to hold their own weight on AR6, which is definitely not a normal AR for a lot of people. You kind of have to look out for this kind of low AR stuff. It's still kind of trippy to me hearing Miserlou and then just Black Eyed Peas on top of it. It's so trippy to me. You check this out right here. Do wanna hate on us, dude. Dude need to ease on up. Dude wanna act on gut, but do get shut like Flavin' Shuck. Chick say she ain't down, but chick backstage when we in town. She like men on drum. She wanna hit and run. Yeah, that's the speed, that's what we do, that's who we be. B-L-A-C-K-E-Y-A-D-D to the E, then the A to the S. When we play, you shake your ass. Shake it, shake it, shake it, girl. Make sure you don't break it, girl. Turn it up.
Louder, 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 louder.
What if every time he says louder, I up the volume like 0.1 decibels. So by the end of the map, it's just like obnoxiously loud. I could do it. It's actually pretty
just
funny.
Just the mic boom.
Okay, I'm gonna do this.
Let's go. All right, that's. That's enough mahjong for today. That's a I got 4 3 times in a row. Alright, let's go, baby. Let's go. South Korea, can they at least get their 5th point on the board right now? They desperately need this to be a successful pick.
Yeah, definitely a little bit more risky here, especially because Nomad reading usually tends to be a little bit more universal compared to hidden reading. Although the precision aspect of this map, definitely a tricky one as well. There is more of an aim element here to consider. A couple more perfect stacks as well.
Absolutely, but everyone's staying perfect except for Choco finding the first mystery 20k lead right now for the United States, right?
Yeah, no breaks just yet on the US. Oh, never mind. There's the break from Haxagon, also known as Tight. Yeah. The score lead is going to very slightly shift over to Korea's side, albeit not by much.
That's the extending jump! Catching three people off guard! And now the three powerhouses in South Korea, as well as a mini one, is still going to fight against Killing Copper. It's a 4v1 Filipino under siege by South Korea.
Yeah, this is looking real bad for the side of the United States. Really, only Filipino holding on to the FC and not exactly with the best accuracy. Meanwhile, for Korea, they got three of them, basically, and one really good supporting score. They were locked in for this one, and it's showing right now. Oh, there goes the almost FC from Square Brackets, but that's fine for them. I think the break from Gilgamesh probably the biggest hit to the US here. There goes Choco, but that's okay.
Got Pierre W! Sibyl. Here comes the sliders! They hit it! Pierre and Sibyl out with the double full combo still coming. But King Copper is there! Just a lurking danger! A lion hungry! Stalking its prey! God, will South Korea fall? They're pumping it! They're pumping it! Louder indeed! It's the big pentagon!
killing Copper, doing his absolute best to hold on to the combo right now. And actually matching Kieris' ag, but Civil Oath is there to shut it down at the moment. The aim not messing up anyone just yet. Oh, there goes Swearing Rackets. Gilgamesh though getting another break, and I almost kind of want to say it's almost over at this point. It's going to take a little bit of a miracle for anything to change here. There goes Civil Oath.
Apir is just slowing everyone down, including killing Copper. And all Apir is going to do is to kill time indeed. 830 combo against another 830 combo. It's a bit of a deadlock. It's a Geometry Dash reference. 220k in the lead. South Korea. Can they force a tiebreaker, Kahli? Oh my god, man. This is going to be so tight.
Yeah, this is going to be a tough one for United States. Unfortunately for them, and now it's going to be up to their last pick. So, I don't know, man. So, Pierre's with the FC in a matchup against Killing Copper. And we also have very good supporting scores from Civil Oath, Choco, and Square Brackets. Hot Bread and Gilgamesh doing their best, but unfortunately not going to be enough for the side of the United States. And now it's time for the final pick for the United States. They have some maps left, but definitely not exactly what they would want to be dealing with at the moment. So, let's see what they go for now. Pump it indeed,
holy.
Oh,
alright, this is, not gonna lie, this is the four worst maps to pick. Nomad 1, Hatterquan, Nomad 3, and Nomad 4 might as well gamble savings. But I do want Nomad 3 though, because it's back.
That's true. There are some interesting maps still left open, especially for the United States. Honestly, if I were them, I would probably just go Hard Rock 1. Call it a day. You know, you shut out their best player on the previous side. Really kind of put them in the back pedal. But the Nomads are still a good option somewhat. Probably the worst pick out of all of them would be Nomad 3 and Nomad 4. But Nomad 1 is still up. They can always do that.
Nomad! They're doing the funny! They're doing the funny! Okay! ZFR, the gorilla in the background! Who is the Iron Okoji to ZFR? Alright, let's see! Oh my god! I'm so ready! This song's so good! You don't get it!
Iron Okoji is ZFR, or the other way around. ZFR is Iron Okoji. So, if I had to take my guess as to who the girl in the background would be,
it is.
No, because I'll be on the other team. Pierre is Iron Okoji. I'm gonna say Hidden Jump is the girl in the background, and Pierre is Iron Okoji.
Okay.
But like for United States, I mean, if we're making ZFR the Iron Okoji, then we may as well say, you know, let's say Gilgamesh is the.
Alright, fair
let's
enough.
Let's say
fair
he's
enough.
The girl in the background.
Yeah, hidden players.
Yes. we're just gonna run with that.
Okay.
That's the standard we're going with here.
Yeah, so. Far wants to get foot so bad, South Korea wants to sleep so bad. I mean.
I don't blame them.
Misery loves company.
It still is 3:30 in the morning for Korea. I think they have every right to be at least a little bit tired, you know?
Oh my god. Alright.
If this wasn't a finals match, I was gonna suggest that I mute the song and you just sing it in the background. But I can't do that. Unfortunately, people are gonna watch this later, so yeah. I don't wanna.
Alright, we need one more. Who is the GOAT? Who is the last person to make a glorious entrance in the side?
It's
South Korea HD jump!
So it's going to be. Yeah, it's going to be a pretty interesting roster from both these teams here. Square Bracket, Choco have played pretty much every map so far. Hidden Jump, definitely a good mechanics player in general, especially in terms of aim. No stranger to ult. And then meanwhile on the side of the United States, kind of just putting in their all-rounders here. You know, killing Copper, yeah. CFR, Hot Bread, Pangeetism. Surprised to not see Gilgamesh on this one, but I guess he's not particularly too comfortable on this type of, you know, kind of alt aim. Mm. So really all on the line here, potential for tiebreaker on both these teams.
Yeah, we shall begin in the Kahli. Number three, in this chess game, there are pawns, but there are also kings and queens. Which one of them can rise up to the occasion? 15k difference, but Hot Breath finding the first miss. Choco tries it out, 3v3 right off the bat.
Yeah, this one is a little bit of a shorter map too, so gotta be a little bit careful with that one. But right now, it's squirrely basically dead even between both these teams here. Nothing too crazy just yet. However, we gotta watch out for those key eyes. The spikes and the aim are definitely notable. Very easy to break on kind of anything. There goes ZFR missing on the accelerated flow. Now it's going to be 3v2, no trade on the side of Korea just yet, but anything could change.
Absolutely, the slow and steady burn. South Korea, slow cooking this minor piece to hell and back. But no, the first game session going to spike quite heavily. Killing cover and pragmatism, still with the double full combo on the other side. Massive combo on their side, but will it collapse in a moment's notice? Pragmatism with a miss. Filipino still trying to hold on, but South Korea dominating. Filipino dominating this minor piece. Absolutely beautiful performance for all four of our players.
Yeah, this one looking really, really good for the side of Korea. No one breaking during these key sections. It's a wipe on the side of the United States. The Boston Massacre visualized again in an OSU tournament. Oh my god, this was a horrible mispick from the United States. I'm not afraid to say it. This is such a bad pick for US. Oh my
Absolutely.
God.
Like, I can't.
They walked it right into Korea's trap, dude. Legit. What is going on?
The United States, they smelled oil in the side of South Korea, but the guerrilla movement of South Korea is just too much for them. 500k in the lead, ladies and gentlemen. South Korea using the no you card against United States nuke, and this number three will explode right on their country. 500k lead, and all they need to do is just to absolutely floss on their dead body into the K section, though, into the solo section. Can they absolutely pour salt all over United States wound? Because this is an absolute destruction we're seeing right now.
Yeah, this is really only one player missing on the side of Korea, Choco, with that early break, but that's not going to matter with Pierre's and Square Brackets holding onto the FC, hitting the hard section and the wiggles. Choco going to get a break, but it doesn't matter. You still got those two FCs. And Jesus and ZF are holding the combo through the hard section, but what are you going to do against the two FCs on this map? And not even the one-third jumps messing either of them up.
Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, what a return! South Korea going the distance, double bracket, going to finally miss at the end, but not before achieving 840k individual scores. We welcome you, the custom, the banger tiebreaker.
Yeah, this is a tiebreaker moment for both these teams, and honestly, given the level of play we've seen from both of them, I think it really could be anyone's game at this point here. So, man, I will personally say, as someone that was trying to play this map, this is hard as hell, okay? Like, really, really hard. Yeah, I think my best score in practice was, like as a four-digit, like, a 1K player, even if I'm not that good. Like, as a 1K player, I played this map in practice, and I think I got 350K at most.
That's messed up.
And Zyfrost got, like, 450K or something? Yeah, I got like a 450k. It's Zeitfrost. Like, what? This is hard as
hell. Oh my god.
So,
oh man, yeah. It is what it is. Holy shit, I'm so ready. Wait.
Oh, goodbye, boy.
Alright, it's time, boys. Beyond reality. Was this a custom song as well, Kahli?
Yes, I believe this is a custom song.
Oh my god!
So a lot of different customs here. New territory for both these teams. I think we're getting a timeout, probably. I think this
is pretty
understandable, the timeout for this one. This is quite literally the decider point of who gets to secure that fourth place and potentially go into the grand finals after the match tomorrow. So, yeah. I think a big thing about this map as well, I should mention, is that it is entirely mechanics heavy. As in, there's really no point in the map where it doesn't become at least a little bit mechanics heavy. So you gotta be on your A game to really get your way through this one. Again, Zeitfrost got 450k. I'm not exactly the best player, but as a 1k player, I got 350k. So maybe these guys are just that goated, but that's kind of the standard you should kind of expect going forward here. So just keep this in mind.
Absolutely. Like, this map is out of this world. So they're just checking it out, playing it to some Filipino Pyrus and HD jumps, just hanging around in the lobby, just chilling dudes, being dudes. And, oh man, my reality is beyond, indeed. Oh my god, I can't wait. I can't wait for this tiebreaker to be played, boys.
Yeah, this is going to be very, very tough tiebreaker. I mean, I think really both these teams here are going to do quite literally everything they can to squeeze every little bit of score, because especially on a TV like this, accuracy and combo, really you can't guarantee anything. Like, you gotta be a certain level of unhinged good. I'm talking like Birchman good, you know? Like the guy that can match up the three digits, like Pikapone, you know? It's kinda, you gotta be like that tier, and even then, it's kind of a hard call to do on a tiebreaker, so. I'm really curious to see who the rosters are for both these teams. Like, I couldn't really tell you. I'd imagine South Korea just throws in Pierres because it's Pierres. Like, he's been doing some work throughout this whole match here.
Yeah.
It's kind of like not having worst HR player in OWC. Like, it's just kind of... like, you're kind of... I don't know if that's the move, man. But...
yeah.
If you think about it, Pierres is actually just worst HR player for 5-digit, right?
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
It makes sense. I think for United States, probably going to be seeing players like ZFR and probably Gilgamesh. I wouldn't be surprised. I think Kiesel and Filipino definitely make the most sense here for United States. Actually, maybe not Gilgamesh. Could probably just see, like, Hexagon's in the lobby, so he's probably going to take the slot here.
Yeah.
Oh, never mind. He's gone. Goodbye. I think for the rest of South Korea, I'm thinking you put in Pierres, you put in Choco, you put in Square Bracket. I'm not sure if maybe they put Kael Vernon, maybe. It seems like he's been in the lobby the whole time. I'm not sure if he's actually gonna stay with it or not, though. Yeah, so Choco, Pierres, Square Bracket, kind of the core three roster we've been seeing throughout most of the match here. A little sad to not see Civil Oath, but you know, that's just the way it is. And it's going to be Tights, Kisoy, Gilgamesh, and Pangeetism for the side of the United States here. Kael Vernon to round out the Korean roster. So, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It's time for the tiebreaker in the Losers Finals. Anything can happen here. A little surprised to not see Hidden Jump on the side of South Korea, but I guess this is a little bit more of like a weirder TB for him. So, you know, understandable.
All right, Pierce, no style, thank God. Holy moly, I'm going to crazy.
Easy would be crazy. Oh my god, don't even make me think about it.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you beyond reality, composed by Nico. It's a tiebreaker, you know what it is, you know what you're in here for. It's 6-6, the stage is on. 8 players will prove their worth in this current map. One map and one map only to prove that you are worthy to continue in this tournament. South Korea, United States, which one of them wants it more? It's been a tight match. But a match shall end soon enough. Let's get right into the first part. Into the spinner.
Got the low beat into the stream in here. Got a couple of cuts to watch out for. There goes a miss aim from Kilburn. A bit of a low section here to look out for. Pierre is dropping a lot of accuracy, actually. A ton of 100s. That's going to tank his score for a little bit. Score lead on the side of the US at the moment. Couple pauses in the rhythm here. Gotta watch out for those wiggles. No one messed up by them just yet, though.
Absolutely. Streams coming in, Calburn. Ampere is just kind of struggling with the accuracy department, probably with the offset. Oh, I don't know, but there's a double miss. That is massive accuracy drop inside of United States. Choco and Double Bracket, they have the chance to bring this back. There's the trade. That's a huge collapse inside of United States. South Korea still holding, but for how long? This is one of the hardest sections. The finger control, the 1-6 burst, and now we're section once more. Three full combo on the board, but the accuracy difference just makes everything in the world right now. United States, can they hold on with their accuracy? There's the combo drop. Only Double Bracket remains. South Korea, is this it? Double Bracket relying on himself and himself only. Only in death does his duty ends. And for he is in the undying, almost misreading that one pattern. Still trying to stay alive, but finally finding a miss. 40k difference. South Korea is in a bit of a danger zone right now.
And right now, really the only comparable accuracy score coming in from Gilgamesh here with a 97 compared to everyone else's about 90-ish, 92. Particularly Kaelburn having the most trouble on this one for South Korea. His score noticeably lower than everyone else's because of the 81 accuracy. But going into the next hard part of the map here, this is pretty tight either way. Like, honestly, if Kaelburn can improve his accuracy, this is gonna be kind of equal from both these teams.
Yeah.
Watch out for the fast section. That's where mess appears. And square break. Bracket. A bit of a speed section coming up here.
Yeah, that's the burst coming in for everyone involved. Ties will find a mess. Still two combo in the side of South Korea. United States having three, and that's a massive advantage. Increasing the lead to 80k right now with no end in sight. Choco and Stage by Mami trading. Beer is still holding. Double Bracket and Ties trading as well.
Oh, the slow slider
catching everyone off guard, but not Gilgamesh. He's the bone of his sword. Tiebreaker is his blood. What was that mess? 100k difference right now. South Korea still has a slider. But half of the map is remaining and time is running out. Time is running short. Gilgamesh and Choco trading it out. Pangatism trying to hold on. Papyrus and Double Bracket trying to pull it back to their side. But this lead is quite massive. Kaelburn trying to recover. Kaelburn trying to survive. Papyrus finally finding yet another miss for South Korea.
The speed section is going to be pretty brutal on everyone here except for Kisloy and Square Bracket. Choco trying his best to recover as well. There's the break from Square Bracket, but Kisloy holding on strong for now. There's the break from him. Choco doing his best. The only combo in the lobby, really. Pierre is trying to make a slow recovery, but his accuracy is still holding him back from a good score. There's the break from Choco, and now it's only Pierre is holding on, but there's the break, and now it's a combo reset, basically, from everyone except for Gilgamesh. And, this might be a bit of a tough situation for Korea. They have 100k to claw back here, but no combo to speak of. There goes Gilgamesh, but he is still at-gapping everyone else in the lobby right now with that 97 compared. So, I don't know, man. This is a bit of a tough situation. Only about a third of the map remaining, and Korea needs a miracle in order for this to come back over to them. Choco doing his best to recover his accuracy, though. That is going to give him a pretty good score. But you can see Kaelburn having a pretty tough time on this one.
Yeah. This is such a devastating position to be in. That's a mystery for Kaelburn and Kisoe. 3v3 right now. South Korea, if they want to perform a miracle, the stage is theirs, but it's called a miracle for a reason. Three men needs to full combo from here on out. No, four. All of them needs
Pierre's
to combo.
And Pierre's
with the play break.
Oh, square break
double
too.
Bracket as well. It's just collapsing in front of our very eyes. United States reaching higher and higher into Nirvana. One last section.
And Choco gonna fall, but still Pangeetism holding onto the combo and Gilgamesh still acting. Gonna take the score up to the 300k territory. No one else really matching up at this point. And I think it's sorry to say, folks, but this map is basically already over as Pangeetism gonna run it away for the United States. And yeah, I don't know. A tough situation for South Korea, but nonetheless, accuracy is the name of the game here. And is going to be United States coming out on top by a pretty good margin, 160k on a tiebreaker, especially one as hard as this. That's a pretty sizable
absolutely
lead.
Quite insane. Gilgamesh with the 97%, Pangatism with the 91%. Call them the beauty and the beast with how they performed in this match. 6-7, United States moves on to face France after this match. That's a good game. And well played. Holy
oh
moly,
my god, the
man.
Slider.
Oh my god, the guys. Slider.
Guys, come on.
Jesus Christ. Dude, that Aquarius step.
Gilgamesh really shredded on the accuracy there. Reminder, not even Zekrom's got 97. So
Mods.
This is the... Yeah, pretty difficult TV, unfortunately, for South Korea. This will be the last appearance we'll be seeing from them in the tournament. In the United States will be moving on tomorrow against France, as you mentioned, that 17 UTC, if I'm not mistaken. So that will be it for this match. However, that's actually not it for this stream. I'll go ahead and let it sit for a little bit longer here, but we got to move straight over to the other match.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, although that is currently being streamed at the moment, I think the plan right now is to have it switched over to me.
All right, nice.
So yeah, we'll be seeing the switch over soon. I'm gonna show the winning screen though. We got ZFR, Sage by Mommy, Meow, and Jizun, Gilgamesh, Hot Red, Tights, and Filipino moving on for the next match.